What's up, everybody watching this video? Yo, what's up to everybody watching this video? My name is Tyler, and today we got another video with the boys. So, aside from the normal feeding videos, this video is going to be a little different. I think I'm going to talk about why anybody would want to have these deadly, aggressive, slimy man-eaters as pets, you know, because they're just so deadly, and just why would anybody want to have, you know, these deadly stranglers in their house that are gonna just somehow unlock their cage or open up their cage and strangle all your children and all your animals and eat your cats throughout the night. So let's talk about that a little bit. First off, basically everything I just said is false. If you are doing your job, even if you have a 12-foot reticulated python, that is not going to be getting out in the middle of the night while you're sleeping and strangling your baby. Because most likely, if you have a 12, 14-foot reticulated Burmese python, whatever it is, you know what you're doing, and that cage is going to be locked at all times. I don't know what's going on here. Hold on. One of the other things I always like to talk about when people ask me why in the world would I ever want to have these things as snakes is because how misunderstood they are. These creatures are amazing. And let me start by saying I have never been bitten by either of my snakes. I may have said in previous videos that this guy, as soon as I got him, he did strike at me, but that was, I mean, literally right out of the box. He struck at me, didn't give him any time. Excuse me. Didn't give him any time to settle in or any of that. So that is to be expected. And after that, I mean, look at this. Look at these guys. They're just absolute puppies. To be honest, they're like stress relievers. For those of you who are only watching this video and aren't a part of my channel, I'm currently in college right now. So these animals, after a hard day, you know, after having class for 8 hours sitting in boring lecture, or in my boring clinical portion, it's just, I come home to them and I literally don't have to do anything but pick them up. You know, I feed them once a week. I clean their cages once, twice a week, but that's it. And for anybody that may be watching this video right now and you're skeptical about getting one, I mean, just look at this. Look at these guys, they're amazing. And they're not gonna rip your head off. They're not gonna rip your face off and strangle you in the middle of the night. Now granted, you might not be as lucky as I am. You might come across one, you know, maybe even your first one. You might get your first one and it's defensive. These snakes aren't biting at you because they want to kill you and eat you. They're biting at you because they're scared, okay? They have somebody that's, you know, 5'11", such as myself, coming at them, and they're these little tiny noodles. Of course they're gonna be defensive. You would be scared too if some giant was coming after you trying to pick you up and you didn't have arms and legs. But anyway, give them a chance is basically what I can say. Another great thing about owning these is giving people who are deathly afraid of snakes, giving them a chance to hold them and interact with them is probably one of the best parts about being a snake owner, to be honest, because I have so many friends that they wouldn't have ever thought of touching these snakes. They wouldn't have ever thought of being in the room with a snake, but they come over, they see me handling them, they see them around my neck, on my head, you know, licking my ear, and they see that there's really nothing to be afraid of. Just getting the information out about these animals is all you really need to do for you know, somebody that's completely skeptical and completely against these animals to start to understand them. Now, a little story about myself. My mom, throughout my whole entire childhood, always told me, no, I could never have a snake. And I think, to be honest, that is one of the reasons why I'm so in love with them, if that makes any sense to you guys. It's just a fascination of mine. And to be told, no, I can't have them my whole life, and now that I'm on my own, you know, it gives me a sense of freedom. And like I said earlier, that sense of stress relief, you know what I mean? I was brought up where if it wasn't something that my parents liked, that was automatically supposed to be something that I didn't like. And I really don't like that philosophy. So I went out and I bought myself a motorcycle and I bought myself some snakes. So so I'm really out there right now, but I'm living the best life I can for the moment. I'm 22, just turned 22 on January 20th, and this is just the beginning of my collection. For those of you who have been watching my videos, I can't thank you enough. The support has been amazing. The comments have been amazing. I just would like to say thank you again. There are a few people that I'm going to thank at the end of the video. Any questions you guys had, I'm going to go ahead and cover at the end of the video. But for now, I'm going to talk about the enclosure that I am going to have my new boa in. All right, so this is basically the necessities of what I'm going to need for the new boa. Now, I haven't picked out a name for her yet, and maybe, I'm not sure, maybe I'll put a picture of her somewhere like right now or so. That yet, but guys, this is basically the necessities of what I need. I've got this aspen bedding, and as you can see right here, I've got this left over, and if you guys can see in there, it's not just the aspen bedding. I do mix in a little bit of eco earth with the bedding, and I've got some over here drying out right now, because guys, this stuff takes forever to dry out. I'm not talking like, man, this stuff takes 2-3 hours. I'm talking this stuff takes weeks to dry out if you have it all wet at the same time. So I've got the heat mat right here. Got the heat mat. This one's for 30 to 40 gallon. I've got the aspen, and then I've got this, I think 40 quart tub. I believe that's what that is. And the breeder that I'm buying from is Rising Sun Boas. And the lady that I spoke with, Amy, she said that this particular boa can stretch the length of a 40 quart. So there's my hand compared to that. As you guys can see, it's a little bit of a larger boa. Okay, so as I was doing that video, this guy decided to slither underneath this lid right here. And I looked down and only S'mores is sitting there, and I kind of freaked out a little bit. I didn't know where he went. So I'm gonna go ahead and put them away real quick, and I will be right back. Okay, so now that we're back, there is a few things that I wanted to mention real quick. So this right here, this heat mat, I was actually out shopping one day, and I was at PetSmart when I bought this, and I was looking at PetSmart's prices for the 30 to 40 gallon, and I believe it was somewhere, don't quote me on this, but it was like $45 or something like that. It was around that ballpark. And I just thought to myself, like, that's a crazy insane amount. And I was actually looking at it, just glancing at it, looking over it, and one of the employees came over and was like, hey, do you want me to price match that for you? And I, of course, was like, yeah, sure. And he took it and he scanned the barcode at the bottom on his personal iPhone. And he was like, oh yeah, it's on Chewy for, it was like $16 or something like that. And I was like, what? And so he told me that there's this app that you can literally take your phone, I think Android or iPhone, and you can go in and scan the barcode. And when you scan it, it shows this list and you can search Google and it'll show you up all the products with the matching barcode on all these different websites. So of course they match Chewy.com because Chewy.com is a pretty big service. So on Chewy.com or whatever it was like $16. So I ended up scanning literally everything that I was going to buy that day, and I saved a crazy amount of money. So I'll post a link of that app down in the description, because guys, if you're not using it, you need to. All right, guys, so to go ahead and end this video, there was one comment that I said that I would address during this video, and his name was Josh Speed. Josh, you said you currently have two bearded dragons, which my mom actually does have two adult bearded dragons. I think I'll throw a picture of them in there. But you also said that you were planning on getting a baby boa. And dude, seriously, I don't know how old you are, I don't know where you live, anything like that. But first off, 100%, make sure you do your research. There's so much information available on the internet. There's no reason anybody should ever have that hard of a time taking care of a baby snake, a juvenile snake, an adult snake, anything like that. There's so much information. There's so many other YouTubes other than mine that you should have an extremely easy time finding the information that you need on these animals. I'm not sure if you ever watched any of my previous animals, but any of my previous videos, but I do address that I am by no means an expert. This channel is to have all my subscribers grow with me as a breeder possibly in the future, but as a snake keeper for right now. So this is a long-term channel. Everybody that's with me is going to grow with me and grow with my snakes as well. With that being said, the best advice coming from myself that I think I would give you is, if your circumstances allow you to get a snake, go for it, 110%. When I was younger, if you're younger, I was not able to get any snakes, any reptiles, anything like that. So if you're able to get them, go ahead and get them. Just make sure you're doing that research. And when you do get them, try and make other people happy with them. Like I said before, that's one of the best things about having these snakes is they're so misunderstood that when people come over, their first reaction most of the time is, ew, oh my God, you have snakes. And anybody else watching these videos that has snakes can most likely relate to that. Oh, why do you have these snakes? Blah, blah, blah. And to just educate them a little bit with the knowledge that I have, and to also let them hold them and let them experience them, is awesome. So go ahead and get that snake. Go ahead and make sure you have the correct enclosure, the right humidity, and all of that, and just have a great time with that snake and have a great time watching it grow. Now, the ending of this video is going to be the last video that I was supposed to upload. I did a feeding time again, but unfortunately, while I was doing it, the whole top of my head was completely cut off, and I hadn't realized it until the very end of the video. So I just scrapped most of the video, but kept the time lapse. So if you guys wanna watch that, it'll be at the end of the video. But thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for all of your comments. Like always, links in the description to all of my social medias. If you have any comments, go ahead and comment down below or send me a personal message. I'll be happy to talk to you guys about anything. So thanks, and I'll see you guys next time.